Hello, giraffe lovers and enthusiasts. Welcome back to the Giraffe Mind with Bookman. In today's series, we shall be looking at some practical video demonstrations of the complete course on reading skills in giraffes. Now, we shall be looking at three reading styles, namely probing, periphmatic shuffle, and move shuffle. Now, on screen, we have a random opening position. And let's begin with probing. Now, looking at Black's position, we can see that Black has an outpost piece which is located at h2 right here. Similarly, White has an outpost piece which is located at a7. This same a7 piece is actually having a cramped activity on this c5 piece, which is a grip lock. Now let us begin with periphmatic shuffle. When doing a periphmatic shuffle, you can begin by looking at the pieces and then you can move to looking at the periphery. So let us begin by looking at the pieces. If you look in White's position, we can see that White has a phalanx, which is these pieces are on to the left side of this position. Similarly, Black has a phalanx also. So that's called a phalanx formation. White has three advanced pieces, which is this piece located at A7, and these two fronting pieces at F4 and H4. Now White's fronting piece is located here at A3, C3, F4 and H4. These four fronting pieces create tension in the position. So let's look at and see what this tension is all about. Now, there's a double tension along these two open spaces in the periphery. There's also a double tensive or double tension along these two spaces between this piece and this piece here. There's also double tension to this flank here. There's a double tension here between these two pieces. And this open square by itself is called a tensive square. Now it's also important to note that this c5 piece in the Black's position is a weak piece, simply because it is being gripped by this white piece in the corner here, so that it cannot advance to b4 nor d4, as Black would lose a piece. Now because we are in the early stages of the game, or the opening phase, we can see that this periphery has a lot of tension in it. Now tension is created when there is little space between the two pieces, or between pieces of opposing colors. Now as you can see, there's double tension along these periphery lines. And there's a tensive square right here, so that does create a very tensive periphery in this position. Now let us look at another sub-technique of reading that we call move shuffle. In this early stage of the game, you don't need to employ a lot of sequence or move sequence shuffle. Just simply move shuffle, that is, shuffling between single pieces which are movable to check their direction, location, placement, activity ratio, interactions, safelet, outcome, etc. Now when doing a move shuffle, the first thing you want to do is to look at the movable pieces in your position. And by movable pieces, I mean pieces that can move legally. Now for instance, this piece might seem to be at H4 a movable piece, but it's not moving legally. Because moving H to G5 would be giving away the piece for free. Hence, that's not a movable piece. So let's look at this piece at F4. This would be 1, piece at C2 would be 2, piece at D2 would be 3, and the piece at F2 would be 4. So in this position, White to move have 4 movable pieces. Now let's look at the movement and the direction, for example. Now this piece in the background at F2, it can move to E3, can likewise move to G3. But going to G3 would be a bad move, since after FE5, White's position in the double corner zone will be cramped, and this second double corner line will be cramped. So that's a poor movement. Now moving F to G5 is a good move, in this case. Might not be the best move. Moving DE3 can also be considered, but this might be a cramped move. Now let's look at this piece at C3. It can move, but to where? It can move to B4 to the flank, but it cannot move to the center since it will be giving away two pieces. Now the game rolls on and we shall see what the computer moves. Now on the first move, White moves CB4, which is a good move. Since what White is trying to achieve is to get to A5 and further cramp Black's position. So the game rolls on and you see that Black moves to the center with FE5, which is a rush on the piece. Now White steps out of the way by moving FG5 and Black rushes the piece. And after the first trade, you see that the nature of the periphery has now begun to change, especially in the White's area of the board. Now we shall continue to look at some more practical demonstrations in the next video. So until then, thanks for tuning in. to the Jaffa Miners Bookman. See you next time.